Sri Gurubhyo Namaha children. In the previous class, I told you about the agriculture, the types of farming, that is primitive, subsistence farming, intensive subsistence farming and commercial farming. Then we went to cropping pattern, that is Rabi, Kharif and Zayar. Now we are going to see about the major crops which are grown in India. See, the major crops, we do have lots of major crops which is grown in India, but the prominent crop or the important crop which is grown in India, which gives where more number of people consume, is rice. Rice is said to be a staple food crops which where the majority of people consume. It is said to be, India is said to be the second largest producer of rice next to China. Rice is usually said to be a crop where it is just sown during the Kharif season, that is on the onset of monsoon, and harvested in September to October. It also requires a high temperature above 25 degrees Celsius and high humidity with annual rainfall above 100 centimeter. Children, you know about humidity, the amount of vapor on the atmosphere. So what happened? It also depends upon the high humidity with annual rainfall above 100 centimeters in the areas, and you do have some of the areas where they do have less rainfall. In that area, even that rainfall should be almost above 100 centimeter. Then rice is grown in the plains of north and northeastern India and coastal areas in the deltaic region. Usually in the southern part of India, the consumption of rice will be more when compared to the northern side. Now we are coming to the next type of major crops, that is wheat. See children, we already know that in the southern part of India, the consumption of rice is more when compared to the northern part of India. Likewise, the consumption of wheat will be more in northern part of India when compared to the southern part of India. It is said to be the second most important cereal crop and main food crop in north and northwestern part of the country, which I told you initially when I started this chapter. It is usually said to be grown in the it is said to be a rabi crop, and it is sown in winter, that is in October to December, and harvested in summer from April to June. It requires almost a cool growing season and a bright sunshine at the time of ripening. So at the time of ripening means almost you do have, when we are ripe in the summer, it is said to be very, having a bright sunshine. The major states where the production of wheat is more are Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan. Almost all these states are said to be the northern states of India. Then the third major crops are millets. Millets, we do have three crops, that is jowar, bajra and ragi. They are said to be a coarse grains. Coarse is said to be a rough grains, that is crystallized grains. They are said to be nutritional value. All these three are said to be a nutrition value, where you get lots of stamina by consuming it. Ragi is almost rich in iron and calcium and other micronutrients. So we are giving you the example how much nutrients it contains, each one of them. In millets, when we are going for the jowar is said to be third important food crops with respect to area and production. That is, almost jowar is said to be consumed by all the people. So it is said to be a third important crop with respect to area and production. It is a rain fed crop, that is, it depends upon the rain, grown in most moist area which hardly needs irrigation. So automatically jowar has a moist areas, and it doesn't need too much of irrigation facilities. Some of the states which depends upon the jowar or which produces jowars are Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh. The second type of millets we are coming, that is bajra. Bajra grows well on sandy soils with shallow black soil. Sandy soil, you already know, which is said to be very much moist in cultivation, and shallow black soil. Some of the states which produce bajra are Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh. It grows well on red, black, sandy, black soil, and almost the states you can see in Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, and Arunachal Pradesh. And the bajra is grown in some of the areas where you can see black soil. Black soil usually it is very much suited for cotton, but even the bajra can be grown in those areas. Maize is a crop used for both food and fodder. Maize is said to be a kharif crop. Kharif crop, already I told you when I was teaching you about the cropping pattern. It is sown on the onset of monsoon and it is harvested in the month of September to October. The temperature for maize, it should be between 21 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees Celsius. It grows well in alluvial soil. Alluvial soil is the best for the growth of maize. Maize can be grown with the use of HYV seeds. HYV seeds, nothing but high yielding variety of seeds where the production will be more, where it can be doubled up, and the fertilizers and irrigation for increasing their production. Now, some of the states which produce maize are Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, and Telangana. The last product which we are going to see is pulses. That is, India is the largest producer of pulses, and India is also said to be the largest consumer of pulses in the world. So why do India consume pulses more? Means it is said to be a crop which is having a protein in a vegetarian diet. So it contains too much of proteins. For that reason, Indian people consume pulses. The advantages of growing pulses is it restores the soil fertility by fixing nitrogen from the air. So the fertility of the soil is being restored when we just have this production of maize. Production of pulses. So the major source of protein in vegetarian diet, and it also major pulses are some of the pulses are urad, moong, peas are grown in India. So on the whole, we can say that the production of pulses not only makes the people to have it, but also it creates the soil fertility to enhance. And finally, we can see the production of pulses is more when compared to the other nations. Thank you.